In recent weeks, we have seen two high-profile characters announce that they are no longer Christians. The first was Joshua Harris, the author of I Kissed Dating Goodbye, who said he was separating from his wife, apologizing to LGBT people and admitting he was not a Christian. Then, the announcement of the Australian composer Marty Sampson, known in the Christian music scene for being part of the Hillsong, said, "I am really losing faith and that does not bother me," during a conversation with evangelist Franklin Graham on Fox Nation. With Todd Starnes, he asked him why he thought those two boys had moved away from Christianity.
To ask you a question about Christianity in general. There have been a couple of big high-profile stories in recent weeks of men who are, you know, I believe as a Hillsong worship leader who renounced his faith or said he was walking away from his faith. The man who wrote the book I Kissed Dating Goodbye, you know, divorcing his wife and stepping back from the faith. What's going on here when you see should people be alarmed when they see leaders like this stepping back from their faith?
Well, first of all, somebody has called them leaders. I don't recognize them as leaders. These are very young people, and I doubt whether they even had a very strong faith or if they even had a faith at all to begin with, and so. For whatever reason, they have decided they're going to turn their back on God and God's standards. And I feel sorry for them. They're in a very dangerous place to be out from under God's protection. And for me, I'm going to keep going doing what I do. I believe the Bible. I believe the Bible to be the Word of God. I believe every word of the Bible. I do not understand it all, but I believe it all. And Todd, we know how God warns in Revelation. He warns churches that turn their back on him. And these young men who have renounced their faith have made it so public. Why are they making it so public? I think they're just wanting publicity. And that's the only reason they've done it. Otherwise, why did they just leave their faith and just be quiet about it? But no, they have to make a big thing about it, trying to get others to follow them to do the same. And I'll just say, shame on them. And you'll stand before God one day and give an account to him.
They were not true Christians. They are young. His faith was not very strong. They could have been atheists. I think they just wanted publicity. Well, first of all, someone has called them leaders. I don't recognize them as leaders. These are very young people, and I doubt if they even have a very strong faith, or if they had a faith to begin with. And so, for whatever reason, they have decided that they will turn their backs on God and God's standards. And I feel sorry for them. They are in a very dangerous place to be under God's protection. And, for me, I will continue doing what I do. I believe in the Bible. I think the Bible is the Word of God. I believe in every word of the Bible. I don't understand everything, but I believe everything. And, Todd, we know how God warns in Revelation, warns the churches that turn their backs on them, and these young people who have renounced their faith have made it so public. Why do they make it so public? I think they just want publicity. And that is the only reason they have done it. Otherwise, why? No, they simply left their faith and kept quiet about it. But no, they had to do something important about it, trying to get others to follow them, to do the same. And I would just say, pity for them, and one day you will stand before God and be accountable. Men were Christian leaders, whether they wanted it or not, because they were in positions of power. Harris wrote a best-selling book, and Sampson's songs spoke to the hearts of millions of Christians. I will continue to do what I do, and I will continue to tell people how they can have a relationship with God, how they can forgive their sins, and how they can do and have that hope of heaven someday. Putting your faith and trust in Jesus Christ, and that should be our prayer for Christian influencers like Mr. Harris and Mr. Sampson. That one day they can really put their faith and trust in Christ, Graham said.